what I have sown. This is my season for grace, for favor. This is my season to reap what I have sown. Y'all listen at this. See, I haven't been perfect.
Happy birthday, Bethany. How you doing? It's gonna be a great day today, and it's raining, but it's gonna be good. But it's gonna be good. Okay, so this is Giovanni
H. Ready? Bishop just received word that today is your birthday. Knock, knock. Who's there? Bert, happy birthday. Love you, man. Thank you so much for all that you have supported me in. And I wish above all things you prosper, be in good health as your soul may prosper. Happy birthday. May the blessings of the Lord be upon you.
Happy birthday. Hey, happy birthday. This is a great, great day. I know you guys are having a great weekend celebrating your birthday. You know, at my age, we don't celebrate just a day or a weekend. I celebrate for the whole week. Once I celebrated for the whole month. I took every weekend, birthday weekend, went out every weekend, had a good time. Listen, that's what I want you to do. God is good. That's why I'm playing this song. The Lord is good, and he's going to take care of you. There's another song on this album that's called New Season, and it's an old song, and I know you know it, but I believe God is doing something in your life, bringing you into a new season. Now, I wanted to get something nicer out to you, a little bit better video quality maybe, but you know things are going on in my life, you know what's happening, and I just wanted to get something out to you as quick as I could and let it be a blessing to you and your family. Don't forget to thank your mother, because without her, you wouldn't be here. So every birthday, always, I call my mom every birthday. Happy birthday. Thank you, Mom, for bringing me into this world and taking care of me. God is good. His mercy endures forever. Have a great, great time. God bless you, son. I love you very much.
To my dear brother, Pastor D. Aaron Sharon, emerging wise master builder in his generation, a man of articulate voice and a wordsmith in the kingdom. Milestones are really important, and as you celebrate this birthday, may it be a high watermark in your journey, in the unfolding of that which God has carved out for you, in your measure of rule and in your sphere of influence. My prayer for you in this season as you enter this new year, that this would be a season of more than success, because success can be fleeting. However, influence and significance are lasting, and it's never too soon to build a lasting legacy built on the significant impact you are making on other people. Continue to be the lover of God's people that you are. Continue to be the lover of learning that you are. And continue to passionately pursue his glory as you do. I love you. The best and the most blessed birthday ever, I pray, be yours this year. Happy birthday.
My son, D.A. Sharon, you are all right with me. And you're celebrating your birthday around my birthday time anyway. Mine's fast. It's yours. 25 years. I can remember when I was 25. Young, vibrant, good looking. I'm still all three of those. And so are you. I wish God's blessings upon you and that everyone will continue to favor you. The hand of God is on you, and I want you to just know that I'm so proud to be your covering, so proud to walk with you. And as they always say, but this is true, the best is in front of you. Your best is even now. And so thank you for allowing me to share and give a good wish for you, for your birthday. The day you were born, it does matter. And you have made tremendous difference in people's lives. But this day, sometimes we need to learn, especially as pastors who give always. And sometimes we need to do something for ourselves. The Bible says, take care of yourself and then the flock. So you celebrate too, and make sure you take some time to do something you enjoy. And it brings a whole excitement to you. You deserve it. We love you, honor you, bless you. We'll come see you soon. Happy birthday.
Al Curley III, I just want to wish Pastor Dominique Charon a happy birthday. You've been doing a wonderful work here, and you've been faithful to the call and faithful to the ministry. And I just want to congratulate you on another year that the Lord has kept you. I truly believe that this year and the years to come are going to be the greatest years of your life. So walk in it and watch God do the rest. You take care. Be blessed.
Hey, though. Pastor D, how are you, man? Yeah, I know I'm a little rough. Yeah, I know y'all got me. But hey, man, I love you, and I want to say happy birthday, man. You are turning 25. Listen, man, we can go clubbing now. Now, y'all, I'm just playing. But you have been a great friend, man. Jesus, dude, I remember when you were 17, just getting ready to start the church in a vision, and now you're 25, man. I praise God for your wisdom, your effort to pioneer something that has been a heart, and I've seen you really plow through those obstacles and rough places, but God have really called you and made you a pathfinder and a pioneer, not just for our generation, but generations to come, man. And I declare the favor of God even upon your life, even the more that this will be the season of the breakthrough and the season of visibility for you, even the more what the city has to come to you for answers.
Hey, man, Bishop, it's your birthday. And we celebrate you. Heaven celebrates you. Eyes have not seen nor ears heard all the things that God has in store for you. We want you to enjoy your day. Sit back, eat, do whatever you want to do. Have a great day as the kingdom of God celebrates and honors what you're doing, who you are to the world, and everything that's about to be accomplished through your hands. God bless you, man. Love you. Happy birthday.
Blessings, Bishop. Just wanted to take time out to wish you a blessed birthday in the Lord. We thank God for this special day, and I pray right now that Holy Spirit will just help me to be short, because there's much that could be said, but I'll just be short in Jesus' name. I just want to thank God for your life and just honor you and celebrate your life today. You have been just a tremendous blessing in our lives. And when I came to Global, I was at a dark point in my life. And you pointed me back to the scripture and pointed me back to Christ when you said, forget everything else and just focus on Jesus. So I'm grateful for that today, how the Lord has brought me from that place. And I just thank God for you just being a spiritual father in my life, not just my pastor, but a role model and someone that I can look up to. And I thank God that when I was ready to throw the towel in and give up when parenting got challenging, that you encouraged me and letting me know that God is going to take care of me and take care of everyone, and all will be well. So I just thank God again. I appreciate all that you do for always sacrificing to making sure that all is well with us. You're not just concerned with us coming on a Sunday and just having a church experience, but you always check in to see how everyone is doing with our family, even those that are extended in the Caribbean or wherever, that you haven't even met them. So we just thank God for your life, and I just decree and declare that this season that you haven't even begun to even see the surface of what God is doing in your life, those dreams that are so big that you haven't even went back to in a while, that God is about to just open doors right now. So we thank God for this season that you'll run, and you'll not be weary, and you'll just be strong, and just be powerful and mighty in the Lord. So be blessed. Enjoy.
Be who God has made you to be. You'll set the world on fire. St. Catherine of Siena. You know, the Bible says that God gave apostles, He gave prophets, evangelists, teachers, for the perfecting of the saints. Think about that. Think about the fact that God gave these men and these women as gifts. They're gifts to us. You know, the thing about gifts, sometimes when you give a gift to a child or you give a gift to a person that's not quite mature to handle the gift, they don't know the real value, the significance of the gift at times. So sometimes we will play with the bowls, or we'll like the box that it comes in, we'll like the wrapping. But oftentimes the real gift itself, sometimes it takes some growing. It takes some time to get used to. Think about my brother, think about my friend, my colleague, Bishop. Think about the fact that he has been a great gift, not only to the countless souls that he has saved, that he has ministered to, that he has helped and befriended, but think about how much of a gift he is to my life. He's a tremendous man with a tremendous vision, a tremendous heart. Think about all the odds that he has overcome, all of the darts that's been thrown his way over the years, his highs, his lows, and yet in the midst of all of that, he still remained consistent to God, the work that he called him to, and his conviction. That's admirable. He's a great gift to the body of Christ and to all those that know him. I just want to say, Earl, happy birthday, and continue to stay faithful to the God that called you and to the work that he called you to. Continue to set New York City ablaze. Love you much. God bless.
Greetings from Atlanta, Georgia. Happy birthday, bro. I miss you dearly. I hope you have a fantastic birthday. I believe that you are the epitome of Christ. Your faith, your strength has such intergalactic range that it spills all over your ministry. It has reached me here in Atlanta. It continues to reach me. I enjoy just watching how compassionate you are for Christ. It just leads me back to the days when we were back home in New York, and I was down a few times, and I remember walking on the promenade and, you know, you praying with me. And I will never forget that day that it was so cloudy outside and foggy, and we bowed our heads and we prayed. And you said, when we lift our heads, these clouds will go away. And little that we knew, those clouds disappeared. And I just hope and pray that God continues to lead you as you lead your ministry and people here. My family loves you. My grandmother listens to you with me on Sundays. We are, you know, always in your corner. Anytime you need me, you know to call me. I hope one day when you're in Atlanta that we can get a chance to hang out. But I'll save all the sad stuff for later. I just want you to enjoy your birthday. You deserve everything. If I were a millionaire, I'd build you a church full of chairs. But God has something greater than that for you. As I mentioned, you know, I'm always in keep you in my prayers. And I hope that God continues to bless you with many more birthdays. I love you, bro. Expect greater. You'll be glad you did.
Hey, Pastor D, this is your friend and buddy, Pastor Tillman. I wish you many, many more birthdays, but most of all, I wish you many more years in ministry as God continue to enrich you and expand you, that you continue to share your gift with the world. You are one unique brother, and we love you. God bless you. Happy birthday and many, many more. Don't eat too much cake.
Wow, it's that time again. Happy birthday, Bishop D.A. Sherrin. You are the best. I love you so much, man. You know, I'm so glad to see the growth. I'm glad to see Global moving forward. I'm glad to see you doing better things and flying everywhere and preaching and reading books and all that, man. I'm just loving the person that you are. Happy birthday. I wish you many more. You know, I live, hope you have, you know, 125 birthdays. You know, I'm just so happy to see the growth, man. I'm just so happy to see, you know, you moving forward. I'm glad to see, you know, you're going to better places. You know, you're the greatest, man. You're the Michael Jordan appreciation. We all know that, you know, you have big plans and stuff, and I just can't wait for the ride, man. I can't wait, you know, we can get that big building in 50 years from now. I'm like, you know, I was there when we was both in the living room talking about, you know, Global and stuff like that, man. I'm just happy. I'm proud of you as a brother. I'm inspired by you. You motivate me to be a better person, to be a better preacher, better reader, everything. I'm a learner because of you. You're my inspiration. You're my hero. Love you, man.